Now, we will see the next part of this chapter, which is differentiability. So, as the name suggests, differentiability is nothing but the property of a particular function to get differentiated at a given point, right? So, before we see differentiability, let's recollect what exactly does differentiation mean. So last year you would have learned differentiation means dy by dx. So the question is, why do we differentiate? By differentiating a particular function, what is the output that we are getting at a particular point? So that's what the topic is going to be. Now, let us consider a function y is equal to f of x. So, when I take a graphical representation of a function y is equal to f of x, let's say there is a function like this existing. Now, to this function, if I draw a secant, so there are three lines that are always associated to any particular curve. One is called as a chord, which is chord is a line segment. Then you have secant and tangent. So, chord is a line segment which is drawn internal to the curve between two points. So both the points should lie on the curve, and if you join those two points, then that particular line segment is what is called as chord. Secant is a line which cuts the curve at more than one point. Similarly, when you talk about a tangent, tangent is a line which touches the curve only at one point. So all these basics you know. So here what I'm doing is I'm drawing a secant. The secant is drawn in such a way that if I take this point as x comma 0 and if I take this point as x plus h comma 0, okay, if I take x plus h comma 0, then what will this point be? So what is point A and point B? So point A will be x comma f of x. Similarly, point B will be x comma f of x plus h, right? Now, we know that every line will have a slope associated with it. So if you recollect the definition of slope from the straight lines, slope is defined like this: y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. In a similar way, if I ask you slope of secant, if I take the secant as AB, slope of the secant AB, then what will you say? So slope is going to be y2 minus y1, that is f of x plus h minus f of x, right, divided by x plus h minus x. So this will be f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So this is going to be the slope of the secant. Now, if I want the secant to appear like a tangent, then what are all the changes that we need to bring in this particular diagram? So observe it clearly. So if I take this as x and this as y, if this is the curve, now here I've drawn the secant between the points A and B, which are little far. Whereas if I draw a secant like this, right, such that this point is x comma f of x, and this point is going to be x plus, I'm sorry, I made a mistake here, it is x plus h comma f of x plus h. Similarly, here also it will be x plus h comma f of x plus h. Okay. Now, if you draw a secant like this, then when is there a possibility for the points A and B to appear as if they are meeting? Okay. So they cannot meet. When can the secant become a tangent or appear to look like a tangent? When you have a curve like this, right? I'm drawing a secant like this, observe. So I'm drawing a secant. I'm still calling it a secant because I am able to define two points A and B. But you will be able to see it as a secant only when I zoom and see. You're able to see some gap here. Maybe if I use a thinner line, you will be able to see. If I zoom and see, it is still touching at two points. Whereas when I see it from here, it is appearing as if these two points are so close to each other. Means when the value of h is approximately 0, or if the difference between x plus h and x is approximately 0, then I can say that the secant gets converted to a tangent. If that should happen, so diagrammatically, this is what is supposed to happen. So in terms of mathematical, that is in terms of condition, if I am able to add a limit of what? If x and x is getting cancelled, h is approximately 0. Means if I am able to do this approximation, limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, then this term becomes slope only, but the difference is going to be, if you are talking about slope of secant, then it is without limit. But if you add the same limit to the secant, then it becomes slope of a tangent. Okay, so slope of a tangent means here we have converted a secant into a tangent by applying the limits. So limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h is what is called as the slope of the tangent, and this is what is technically called as, and this is what is technically called as dy by dx, that is derivative of y with respect to x. And dy by dx is what is written as f dash of x at certain times, or you can write it as y with a dot on top of it, or you will write it as y dash. All the equations mean the same, or you can write it as derivative of f of x with respect to x. Okay, all these three mean the derivative of y with respect to x, and mathematically this is equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h, and this is what is called as the first principle of derivatives. So this is what you would have learned last year. This is called as the first principle of derivatives. So from now on, if someone asks you, why do we differentiate? You differentiate to find the slope of a tangent at a particular point. So in this chapter, you will learn about how to differentiate. In the next chapter, we will apply these concepts. So when you're applying, you should have a clarity of why do we differentiate. So I'm repeating it. Why is differentiation done? Differentiation is done for a given function to find the slope of a tangent to the given curve. So every function is definitely going to be represented as a curve, right? And that mathematical formula is going to be limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. Now one last point is, this is the general equation for differentiation. The next subtopic will be differentiation of a function at a given point C. So differentiation of a function at a given point C means, it will be like this, limit h tends to 0, f of, One small change that you're supposed to make here is, in the place of x, replace it with c. That's it, as simple as that. It is going to be f of c plus h minus f of c divided by h. This is what is called as dy by dx. One difference is, you will put a line like this and write at x is equal to c. How you read is, you read it as dy by dx at x is equal to c. So this is what is called as the slope of the function, slope of the curve at point C. So this is called as slope of curve at point C. So this is going to be the basic of the next chapter. So I'm just revising what we have learnt in your 11th standard. In your 11th, you would have learnt it till here. Okay, this is a slightly extended concept. So differentiation of a function at a given point. So it is going to be the slope of the curve at a given point. In this year, this is also called as the right hand derivative of a function. Okay, so what is this right hand derivative, and there is a counterpart to it which we call it as left hand derivative. We will see it in the next video. So I'll just give you an outline. See how, like for example, you wanted to prove the continuity of a function, what is that we did? For continuity, we took the left limit and the right limit. Similarly, if you need to prove that a given function is differentiable, then you need to take the left-hand derivative and right-hand derivative, out of which the first principle of derivatives represents the right-hand derivative of a function at a given point. Have this in your mind.